Hello everybody. Welcome to CSC 201, Introduction to Computer Applications. My name is Robert Griffith and I'm the instructor for this class. I've been teaching computer applications with Mendocino College since 1998, I believe it is. Could be 1997. Back then when we started out, very few people had their own computers at home. And so many of you will be taking this class on a computer, some will be doing it on a tablet, some will do it on a laptop, some will do it on a desktop. So a few people, you know, may even be doing it on an iPhone. I'm not quite sure what everybody's doing right now. It's a changing class, and that's one of the reasons this class is going to be a little different for you this semester. There are other CSC 201 classes that do the traditional buy the textbook, you know, kind of follow through all the lessons and everything, and I'm trying something a little different this semester, but I'll be explaining that a little bit more in a couple minutes. Why do I do a video introduction like this? Well, really, I do it because I feel like it's impersonal when you just sign up for a web class and you never see the instructor or talk to the instructor or anything. So, not that I want everybody to, hey, look at me, but I feel like it's a chance for you to get to know who I am, kind of know who you're talking to if you're sending me an email or something. And so I hope it helps in some way. I also try to cover some of the important information, and this is a way to get people to watch it and, you know, get a chance to hear it as well as read it. Some people do fantastic in an online environment. Some people will go through the class, cruise right along. They already feel comfortable with computers. They can do all the lessons. They've used Etudes even before, and some people, this is their third or fourth or fifth online class, so they can kind of cruise through some of these things. If you're someone who needs a lot of support, who needs a lot of questions answered, especially when it's related to technology, this might not be the course for you. If you're taking this class because you want to learn how to use your computer, for example, some of these things, like I'm going to have you do work, and a lot of it's going to be on your own, and you'll be following along with some online tutorials and reading along with some instructions. And then I'm going to have you save a document, send me an email with the documents attached, so that you kind of need to feel a little comfortable with your computer. I'll be going through some of the basics, and I think this is a doable class for most people. So if you get in it and you're frustrated, don't give up. A lot of people will do great. All right, now if you're in the summer program, we only have 6 weeks. So we have like one entire week devoted to Microsoft Word or word processing, and a week, you know, dedicated to Excel or spreadsheets, for example. And we have classes that spend an entire semester on Microsoft Word or an entire semester on Microsoft Excel. So we're going to be doing a lot of stuff. If you're in the longer term course, you'll be doing more than 1 week per section, so it's a little bit easier. And that takes me to the reason I mentioned that is I would like you to know that if this is too much for you, you can take it during the regular school year also, during the regular session, spring or fall. Okay, so in an online environment, a teacher doesn't really have the chance to do much direct instruction. And one of the consequences is there's not really a good chance for anybody to ever ask questions or ask for clarification. So you can send an email, and if I've already checked my email for that day and I don't see it until the next day, you're waiting a day to get a response on an email, and you know it can get kind of tricky. So I do have things put into the Etudes system, such as a chat room and message forums and stuff where people can ask for help. And I developed a Facebook group if you're interested in doing that. But it can be difficult. So an online instructor is more of a guide on the side. They kind of point out where the lessons are, tell you how to find things, and you kind of do it on your own. Whereas in my face-to-face classroom sessions, I'm more of, I don't want to say the sage on the stage, but that's kind of what it is, where you have the person in front of you explaining things and answering questions and whatnot. All right, and so again, it can be tough for people who aren't comfortable with computers. Okay, so this course over the summer is 6 weeks long. All right, we have week one is kind of introductions and using Etudes and computers and the internet, and it's a lot of a lot of stuff. Week two is word processing, usually Microsoft Word, but like I said, we'll be using Google Docs as well. Week three is spreadsheets or Microsoft Excel. And we'll be also using Google Docs for that, just as a supplement. Week four is going to be presentation software, typically PowerPoint. And then week five is graphics and graphic editing. And I'm just going to show you some of the basics for that because it helps to know that in a computer, especially if you're trying to edit something to put on a cover or, an essay cover page or something. And then week six is a final. And it's not a final exam. It's a final cumulative simulation thing. I'm going to have you do block letters and apply for a job and things like that, probably. Again, just a reminder, with an online environment, don't get behind, because a lot of people will think, oh, I can just catch up the last week or so of class. And then they get there and suddenly they realize they have hours and hours and hours of work. And some people just never recover from that. So don't get behind. Online classes have a high attrition rate. It just means that a lot of people will be dropping the class. And I can't really do much about it other than tell you don't drop. Just hold on, do your best, and let me know if you're having problems. Sometimes you have to drop, and I totally understand that too. Okay, so a little bit about me. As I said, my name is Robert Griffith. Been teaching at Mendocino College since 1997 or 1998, but I started at Mendocino College as a computer lab aide back in 1986. And so I spent 5 years as a computer lab aide there doing some programming and doing database work and that kind of thing before I finished my degree and came back to teach. I love Mendocino College. I've not been there from the beginning, but I've been there since we only had the one main building and the library was just opened. So it's been kind of an interesting journey to see it evolve into the amazing thing that it is today in our community. And, I love the students there. I've kind of grown up. As I said, I started in 1986 when I was 18, and so now I'm 47. So it's been a journey, but I really love the faculty. I love the staff at the college. Seen a lot of changes over the years, but online instruction is something that is been around for several years, but it's getting better and better. I began my teaching career with Mendocino College. I also did 7 years at Ukiah High School teaching computer science. We did graphic design, 3D graphics, web design, 3D modeling, video production, that kind of thing. I later spent 5 years at Kelseyville High School over in Lake County, and we did the same kinds of classes, business, personal finance, 3D graphics, programming, photography, that kind of thing. I also have taught at Terrace Middle School and at Pomelita Middle School. I taught history. And now that we have moved out here to East Tennessee, we're in a place called Rocky Top, Tennessee, believe it or not. And I'm teaching at Jellicoe High School up on the Kentucky border, which is very different from where I come from. But I'm teaching U.S. history, world history, and economics, and honors U.S. history, and next year AP U.S. history. I do miss computers and business, teaching that face-to-face, so I'm still looking. But hopefully by the time you see this, I'll have a job doing business or computers again. Okay, and I'm married. I have 5 kids of my own. Well, we have 4 kids that are our birth kids and 1 little girl that we adopted when she was born. We brought her home from the hospital. But my twins are 21. My next oldest son is 18. Then my daughter is 14. She's going to be a freshman this year. And then I have Maya, who's going to be 3. And we also do foster care. So we currently have 4 foster boys. And their ages are 4, 2, and the twins are 8 months old. So there may be times when I'm tired or not thinking clearly or really, really busy, and I apologize in advance, but I'm hoping to have that all kind of ironed out before we get underway with our classes. All right. We really like where we live. I do miss California. Things like the broiler steakhouse, you know, they just don't have that here, and they don't have pizza out here. Oh my gosh, the pizza's horrible. Anyway, I won't get into all that. Okay, so the big question that everybody always wants to know right in the beginning, what textbook do we buy? And the answer is, I'm experimenting and we're not going to have a textbook this semester. We tried it last semester in my full-time regular class, and so I'm going to try it again and hope that it works as well as it did. It's a lot of work, but it saves you $100 plus on the textbook. And what I would like people to do, and the reason I'm doing this is not because I want to get away from a textbook, but because I want people to use something they're comfortable with. I can teach Microsoft Office, you know, 2015 or whatever we're up to at this point, but then a lot of people won't have that version. Or some people have a Mac, or some people are doing theirs on a tablet, or some people are doing theirs on an iPhone, or some people have some kind of weird notebook computer that only runs Google Docs, you know, those kinds of things. And so I'm trying to find a way to get all of that to work. All right. And so that's another reason I'm trying this. And I thought if I could do it in a way that you could pick a support book of your own, something that you like, go to a used bookstore or a garage sale. And, you know, let's say you have Office XP and that's the newest one you have. Go find a Office XP book for a dollar and use it as a reference, not as a, you know, these are the steps to do the projects. I'm trying to change up the way that this class has been done. Now, that being said, I have a lot of projects, but I tried to give you video tutorials and those kinds of things for you to do those. There's a place called GCF Learning that has free online tutorials, kind of like a virtual textbook almost. And I'm going to assign some of those modules for you as well. So I hope it works for you. And again, if not, it's okay to drop and to take it during the regular semester or to take it with another teacher that requires a specific textbook. I'm trying to really help people as much as I can. And it's a lot more work for me because I can't just say, oh, look in the book on page 32 and read that section. It's a lot of, okay, what program are you using? What platform? And that kind of thing. So it's harder for me. So don't think I'm doing it to make it easy on me. But if it doesn't work for you, let me know that too, and I will maybe try to change some things up. Etudes is, I don't want to say a bad system, but it's growing on me, and it is evolving into a better system, so that's a good thing. All right, so but we'll talk more about Etudes later also. Okay, so this is the Etudes website, kind of the way you'll see it. And you may see a different video on the screen, or the CSC welcome maybe a little bit different, but this is generally what you'll see. You'll notice that there's a home. The announcements are these things over here. So if you ever want to scroll back and go through some old ones, you can click on announcements. There's one thing that says syllabus here. And if you click the syllabus, yours is going to look a little different than mine because I'm the teacher, obviously. But if you click on the syllabus, it'll show you the syllabus. And I try to keep this updated. I've got the current schedule on there. You can also go to the bottom and download the PDF version of the syllabus if you'd like to have that copy. When you go into the modules, you'll see that there's a whole bunch of modules. All right, so I have them broken down into weeks to make it a little bit easier for you, I think. Week one is the getting started stuff, and you can see here how it goes over Google accounts and Google Drive and computers, and then some technology hardware training and whatnot. All right, and then we're going to be going into a little bit of the basics of image editing, not anything, you know, fancy. And in the next one is week two, and that's word processing. And you can see that I've got, you know, not a whole lot of projects for word processing. And then week three is spreadsheets, and there's quite a few spreadsheet projects. And, you know, but basically this is the way you would go and do your modules. All right. And then Over here on the side, you'll see there's a section called Discussion and Private Messages. Now, Discussion and Private Messages is exactly as it sounds. You'll see the About the Class thing here, and you'll see these things over here. If you have questions about Google or email or whatever, Microsoft Word or Word Processing, Excel or spreadsheets, and you can go in there and ask and answer questions. I'd appreciate it if you'd answer questions also. Questions about the class, you can ask in there. As you go down and these things open up, you'll see that we have the introductions week where you'll be posting who you are, the assignments for week 2, week 3, week 4, week 5, week 6, and then up here there's a section called private messages. And if you click that, you'll see all the private messages you have received. So hopefully you can go in there and you can send me a private message from here, and I will be able to open them and respond. Now, just a heads up, I typically don't check my private messages a lot. I really rely a lot on email, all right? And then finally, there's a section called the chat room, and it just says chat. And if I was to go down here and type the message, and I'll just say, this is a test. Now, when you come on and you go to the chat room, you should still see my this is a test thing in there. And the reason is because once you type something in the chat room, it stays there. So I mention that because we've had people in the past that logged in and they were talking about somebody, and then they thought it was just going to be gone when they left. And then that other person came on and saw some things written about them, and we had to have some discussions. So I just wanted to let you know that. You'll also have a thing that says account. And your account name will have, you know, all of your user ID and stuff, your avatar or the picture that you want to use for your page. It'll have your email address, and I need to have a valid email address because I will be sending you emails through here. All right, and so if you have any questions about this, let me know. And all of your courses that you take through Etudes should be across the top. Thank you very much, and let me go back to my main class here and go back to my, I don't know, my discussions and private messages. And I'm all ready to go. So I hope that works for you, and let me know if I can do anything. Thank you very much.